astronomy, I think, is one of our oldest sort of cultural enterprises. People really want to know what the universe is like around them. And it's something that I think enriches us all if we find out how the universe is working. I was doing mathematics at university, but I saw a flyer to go to Mount Stromlo for vacation studentships. That worked out very well. I was kind of hooked. I went to Cambridge to do graduate work, and then 1967, I came back to Australia, and I've really been here ever since. Well, my first big discovery was during my thesis time, and I built some analytical models of galaxies that are now called Freeman-McLaurin models. And then the next one, I think, was the discovery in 1970 that led to the indications of dark matter in galaxies. Our Milky Way is a spiral galaxy. It's just a flat galaxy, about 100 billion stars, held together by gravity. And what we were able to do was work out how much gravity there actually was. And then when we compared that with the existing data, we could see immediately that there was a misfit, that there had to be a lot more gravitating material than we could account for in terms of the stars that were there. Only about 3% of the mass of the Milky Way is in the form of material that we can see. The remaining 97% is what's known as dark matter. It really completely changed the idea of how galaxies came together. Well, today I'm putting most of my efforts into trying to understand how our own Milky Way came together. And we're using a lot of chemical techniques in particular to try and understand this. We call this galactic archaeology because we're probing back using fossil remains of star formation events that occurred very early in the life of the galaxy. This approach, which was developed by my colleague Josh Bland-Hawthorne and me around 2002, and we're carrying this forward now. This is really our main thrust. We've been pushing for a long time to have an instrument built that would allow us to measure high-resolution spectra, so we can measure chemical abundances for many elements for a large number of stars. The instrument's called Hermes, and it will be ready next year. And our goal is to measure a sample of about 1 million stars so we can really build up the star formation history of the Milky Way. Mentoring is very important to me. The subject depends on the new young people coming into it. I've had 54 PhD students. 5 of them have got Hubble fellowships, which are the most prestigious of the postdoctoral fellowships. It's a very rewarding and exciting thing to be involved in.